Hello. I am Stéphane Farou and I am going on with SQL Horror Stories. This time I am going to talk about duplicate rows in results. Whenever you mention duplicate rows, everyone usually says, ah, Cartesian joins. Cartesian joins are, as you probably know, named after René Descartes, a great 17th century mathematician and thinker. If you say, let's show a movie title and a director's name next to it, by getting information from movies, credits and persons, and filtering on persons that have role D in the credits table, and if you write this query, the result will run for pages and pages, and is obviously not what you want. Why? Well, we join movies to credits and have a condition to link one to the other. But we also have the persons table, and I voluntarily forgot to add the condition to link it to the other tables. The result is that I display all possible combinations of a row from persons, with a row resulting from the preceding join, and I get the dreaded Cartesian join. Very often, you are told this wouldn't happen if you were using ANSI joins. In an ANSI join, the condition that links two tables together is moved up in the from clause, and my query would become something like this. And here, I would get a syntax error because after a join, a non-clause is expected. Although I am myself in favor of the ANSI join, it's not because it protects against Cartesian joins. In fact, you can still have Cartesian joins with syntactically correct ANSI-style joins. Suppose that you have a table of transactions in various currencies and that you want to convert all amounts into a base currency using the exchange rates table. If you join the two tables on the currency code, you will get a syntactically correct ANSI join and a Cartesian join nevertheless, because exchange rates change daily. You must also join on the date, because the real key is currency plus date. If the Cartesian join is a very convenient scapegoat, in fact, involuntary Cartesian joins are a mistake that you usually spot very easily, because either you get rows and rows and rows when you have no aggregate, or you get very big numbers with counts or sums, and with min and max values, you get the same values everywhere. I'd like to rush to the rescue of Descartes and say that if duplicate values are a big issue, the really tough cases with duplicate values are much more subtle than Cartesian joins, and I am going to give you an example. I have a table of movies, a table of persons, and a table called credits that says in which movie each person was involved, with a row that says A for actor and D for director. I am going to return all persons, join all of the tables together as they should be, and count in how many movies each person was involved, and return as well the year of the oldest and most recent movies. I need to group to aggregate by person, and I am going to limit the output to persons that were involved in more than one movie in my database. Here is the result I get with the data I have. This result is correct, but the query is wrong. To prove it, I am just going to add one movie to my database, The Fearless Vampire Killers. When I run the query again, Roman Polanski is added to the result set, and although I couldn't see him before, which means that he was at most involved in one movie, and I have added a single movie, my query says that he's involved in three movies, which is obviously wrong. What happens is that he's involved twice with the Fearless Vampire Killers, as director and as actor. I have counted twice this movie, I should have counted it only once. I get a result set that is correct for most rows, and wrong for some of them, something which is much more difficult to spot than a plain Cartesian join. To understand what is wrong with the query, let's go back to Ted Codd and the relational theory, but I'm going to simplify it a lot. I am going to represent a relation by an apple. The theory says that you can apply operations to a relation, such as filtering rows with a where condition. that turn a relation into another relation. You can also take a relation, combine it using a join or set operator to another relation, and get a third relation as a result. Now the question is, what is a relation? And very often people say or think, a relation is a table. This is wrong. A relation can be represented by a table, but all tables don't represent relations. One key feature of relations is that they contain no duplicates. Another way to put it is to say that each and every row can be uniquely identified and distinguished from any other row. If a table contains duplicates, it's still a table, but it's no longer a relation. And when you combine a relation with a table that is not a relation, the result can be anything. You have no guarantee that it will be correct. Correctness is only guaranteed with relations. Let's return to the query that I have said to be wrong. If you see it primarily as a join between persons, movies and credits, think again. It's in fact a join between a subset of persons, a subset of movies, and a subset of credits. If we consider persons, we use in the query the name, the first name, and the identifier. Born and died are not used, and it's exactly as if we were operating on a table with only three columns. This table is a relation, since rows can be uniquely identified by either the identifier or the combination first name name. For movies, we only use year released and the identifier. We ignore title and country. But this two-column table is still a relation, since it contains the identifier. But for credits, we only use person ID and movie ID. We don't use role that is a part of the key. The subset of credits that is used in the query is not a relation, because whenever someone directs and plays, we will get duplicates, not only with Polanski, but Chaplin, Wells, Allen, Eastwood, and many others. This is the orange that we are mixing with apples. One way to correct the query is to only count distinct movies by inserting the distinct keyword in the count. But there are other ways to do it without changing anything to what is selected. For instance, we can turn the orange back into an apple by selecting only distinct pairs of person and movie identifiers, thus turning what used to be a portion of the key into the full key of this subset of table credits. Another possible option, which is probably what I would choose, is to ensure that the join between the true relation, that is the subset of persons, with a subset of credits, is a true relation and that each row occurs only once. As we know that there is no problem with movies, the final result will be correct. To conclude, to be sure that the results you get are correct, you must respect the premises of the theory, and remember that if tables must have a key, result sets must also have a key, including intermediate result sets. If you respect this simple rule, there is no reason to have duplicate rows and wrong aggregates, and there is no reason for horror tales. Thank you.